Hello dear students, today we are going to see a very important chapter, that is natural resources. Natural resources are any material given to us by the nature which can be transformed in a way that it becomes more valuable. They are also known as earth resources as they are obtained from the earth. They can be classified on three bases: chemical nature, distribution and availability. So, in chemical nature, they can be divided into three types, that is inorganic, organic and mixed. In case of distribution, they are divided into three types: national resources, which is confined to a particular nation; multinational resources, which are confined to two or more nations; and international resources, which are available internationally, example air. Then comes the availability. Based on availability, there are two types: inexhaustible and exhaustible, which get exhausted after a particular period of time. Exhaustible are again divided into two types: non-renewable and renewable resources. Natural resources have various problems associated to it. First is unequal use of natural resources, that is the developed countries are having less population and they are using major extent of natural resources as compared to other developing countries which are not using natural resources properly. Then there is a threat to natural resources due to overpopulation. The demand is more than supply, so because of which there is a threat to natural resources. Some of the examples of problems associated with natural resources is, for example, problems associated with land resources are soil erosion, non-agricultural use, agricultural use, landslides, degradation, desertification. Problems associated with water resources are quantitative depletion of water resources, that is fall in the level of underground water level, and qualitative degradation of water resources, which means use of external pollutants like fertilizers, pesticides, industrial effluents or sewage into the water. Then comes problems associated with mineral resources, that is mining damages the land, it destroys the nearby vegetation, and mineral processes causes air, water and soil pollution. Problems associated with biological resources are deforestation, and humans are also destroying the habitats of animals, causing their extinction. Now we'll move towards the first resources, that is forest resources. India covers only 11% of the land under forest, but ideal requirement of forest is 33%. So there is a need to increase forest cover in India. Now forest, they have various benefits, like they provide oxygen and wood for furniture. Other functions include functions of forest. They can be divided into three sections. First is ecological functions, that is what are the functions of forest towards the ecology. Okay, so first is watershed protection, that is they reduce the rate of runoff water, they prevent floods and soil erosion, and they produces gradual runoff and thus prevent the effect of drought. Second is atmospheric regulation, that is they absorb the solar heat during evapotranspiration, maintain the carbon dioxide level into the atmosphere, and also maintain the climatic conditions. Now forest, they also do the erosion control by holding the soil, okay, and they act as a land bank, that is they maintain soil nutrients and their structure into the soil. Then comes the local use, that is the use of forest products by the local people. For example, food is used, okay, then fodder is used for cattle, fuel wood is used for cooking. Poles are used for building the homes. Timber, which is obtained from forest, is used for household articles. Fiber is used for weaving of basket. Sericulture is used for silk. Apiculture is used for obtaining the honey. And medicinal plants are used for the medicines. Okay, so which can be a potential source of new drugs. Then comes the market use, that is the forest products can be used by the local people to sell into the nearby market, and it can be act as a source of livelihood. Okay, so minor forest products are what? Fuel wood, gum, fiber, okay, which are collected and sold in the local markets. Then major timber extraction. Okay, major forest product is timber, which can be used for construction, industrial purpose, paper pulp, etc. Then we'll move towards the problems associated with forest resources. Major problem is deforestation. Now, what can be the causes of deforestation? That is the natural causes and man-made causes. Natural causes are floods, droughts, cyclones, earthquakes, or diseases, etc. Then man-made causes are shifting or zoom cultivation. Okay, that is they cultivate the crops by burning the part of forest. After some years, they shift to some other place and do the same. Then comes the population explosion. Okay, so the forest products, more and more forest products are required due to population explosion. Then comes the increasing demand for timber to prepare various products like furniture, matchstick, paper, plywood. Okay, then forest products are also used for construction of road and railway lines. Okay, so if you want to construct the road and railway lines in mountain areas, then you have to do the deforestation. So this is also one of the cause of deforestation. Then overgrazing, fire by human activities, major cause of deforestation. Mining process. Okay, so when you are to do the mining, you have to do the deforestation in that particular area. Urbanization, you already know, to create urban areas and to create the development, deforestation have been done to major extent. Then comes dams and hydel projects, which have submerged a lot of forest and displaced the local people. What is the effect of deforestation? There is an increase in frequency of flood and drought, then decrease in capacity of the soil to retain water, so thus it causes decrease in underground water level. Soil erosion, there is decrease in soil fertility, desertification, wild species are becoming extinct. Increase in concentration of greenhouse gases, there is a depletion of ozone layer. Increase in landslides is there because no roots are there to hold the soil. Okay, and there is an imbalance in atmosphere, and there is a decrease in rainfall and change in pattern of rainfall. Then comes the effects of other problems on forest, that is timber extraction and effect of mining. So these are the two minor problems which are related to deforestation only. Then conservation of forest. How will you conserve forest? So number of cut trees should be replaced with at least equal number of trees. That is, you have to do the afforestation. You can plant trees along roadsides, railway lines, and river banks. You should minimize the use of fuel and wood, which will reduce the deforestation. You can use smokeless and fuel-efficient chulas. Then, instead of fuel wood, you can use alternative sources. Protect from forest fires. You can avoid overgrazing. If you want to do the deforestation, you can cut the mature trees and should be replaced with the new one, which is known as selective cutting. Alternative cutting of trees instead of whole forest should be done. So with this, we can conserve the forest. Various afforestation programs have been introduced by the government. First is the social forestry program, that is afforestation in the public and common lands. Agroforestry program means using the same land for farming, forestry, and animal husbandry. Urban forestry program, growing ornamental trees in urban areas. And extension forestry means planting of trees along roads, railway lines, canals, and wasteland. Now, this is a case study which is related to the conservation of forest resources, that is Chipko Andolan. It was in protest to the continuous deforestation which was taken in Tehri Garhwa region. It was led by Gauri Devi, and then it was popularized by Sundarlal Bahuguna. So to prevent the deforestation, the local people actually hugged the trees and also faced the police firing because they were not allowing the deforestation, and this has led to deaths of many people which have participated in the movement. Now we'll move towards the next one, that is the water resources. Water resources, 97% of the water resources is in the ocean, 2% is in the polar ice cap, and only 1% is available as a freshwater resource. So, how water resources are maintained? They are maintained by the natural water cycle. Any change in the water cycle lead to decrease in the availability of fresh water. Now, what are the functions of water resources? Water is used for drinking, cooking, bathing, and washing clothes. They are also used for disposal of sewage and organic waste. They are used for the disposal of industrial waste. They are used to generate electricity. They are also used in industries, in construction, for irrigation, and they are also used for rearing of fish and other aquatic organisms. Now, what are the problems associated with water resources? That is water scarcity, water pollution, flood, drought, then water conflicts and what you can say, crisis and conflicts over the water, in which national and international conflicts. And then comes the international conflicts, and then comes the dam. So we'll see one by one each problem. First is water scarcity, which is due to the overpopulation. There is no enough water to drink, which is leading to water scarcity. Water pollution, pollution of surface water resources such as rivers, lakes, and canals take place. Now, what are the causes of water pollution? Flow of untreated sewage in water, throwing industrial effluent in the water resource, flow of farm runoff, flow of hot water from the thermal power plant, and soil particles which are coming due to soil erosion, which makes the water turbid. Then comes this third problem, that is the floods. Now, submerging of very large area underwater, which can harm the living organisms, is known as the flood. Now, flood occur due to excessive flow of water in the monsoon season. Now, what are the causes of floods? First is the deforestation. Then, water absorbing capacity of the soil decreases due to deforestation. If there is a crop cultivation in wetlands and there is a destruction of wetlands which act as a flood controlling system, and some landslides block the way of the river, and because of which water gets accumulated in the upstream area, which results in floods. Then comes the drought, which is the major problem in the arid and semi-arid region, which is due to the unpredictable climatic conditions and failure of monsoons. Now, what is the effect of drought? It leads to periods when there is a serious scarcity of water to use in farm, and it also leads to food shortages and malnutrition in children. Okay. One of the factors that worsens the effect of drought is deforestation. Now, for this drought-prone areas, development program have been developed in which people are given wages in bad years to build roads, minor irrigation works, and plantation program. And how you can prevent the drought? Soil and water management and afforestation are long-term measures with which will reduce the impact of drought. Then comes water crisis and conflicts over water. Water is essential natural resource, but due to overpopulation and carelessness of human beings, there is scarcity of water, and because of which this has led to conflict over water sharing between nearby countries or nearby states. So first we'll see the national conflicts which is occurring in our India, in our country. First is Kaveri water dispute, which is between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, and second is Satluj Yamuna link canal dispute, which is between Punjab and Haryana. Sone canal dispute is between Bihar, UP and Madhya Pradesh. Yamuna water dispute is between Haryana, UP, Delhi, Rajasthan and Himachal Pradesh. Then comes the international conflict. First is the conflicts in the Middle East, that is taking place between three river basins of Jordan, Tigris, Euphrates and Nile. Okay. So, Turkey is in dispute with Syria and Iraq over the sharing of Tigris Euphrates. There is a dispute between Egypt, Ethiopia and Sudan over Nile River, and there is a dispute between Israel, Syria and Jordan, Lebanon and Palestine for the river Jordan. Okay. Then second is Sindhu Water Agreement, which was done between India and Pakistan. According to this agreement, Chelab and Chenab River will remain with the Pakistan, and Ravi Bias and Satluj will remain with India. But India has the right to construct dams over Pakistan rivers in its territory. So these were the two international conflicts. Now we'll see the last problem associated with water resources, that are the dams, which are mainly constructed to provide water for drinking, irrigation and industrial use. Now what is the problem caused by dams? It include fragmentation and physical transformation of river. It is causing serious impact on riverine system. There is a social consequences due to displacement of people, water logging and salinity. There is a dislodging of animal populations and damaging their habitat. Fishing and travel is getting disrupted and there is a change in the microclimate. Now controversial projects include Sardar Sarovar project, Tehri Dam project and Bodhghar project. How will you conserve the water resources? Build small reservoirs instead of large dam projects. You can do afforestation, prevent wastage of water, prevent cultivation in wetlands, prevent irrigation wastage by using wiser irrigation techniques like drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation, rainwater harvesting, avoiding pollution of water, treatment of polluted water, making bunds and avoid construction of dams. Case study related to water resources is water pollution in Nepal. The Narayani River, okay, has been polluted by the factories located on its bank, and it has endangered many aquatic animals like dolphins, crocodiles in this region. Sardar Sarovar project, this is the second case study. You must have heard about the Narmada Bachao Andolan. This is the Sardar Sarovar project. So World Bank, which was funding this Sardar Sarovar project, it withdrawed its funds from this, okay, because the local people threatened with the loss of their livelihood and homes in the submergence area. This dam in Gujarat on Narmada has displaced thousands of people and they were also lost their homeland, okay. So because of which World Bank, they withdrew their funds, and the Narmada Bachao Andolan was carried out under the influence of the activist Medha Patkar. Now we'll move towards the mineral resources. We have seen forest resources and water resources. This is the third resources, that is mineral resources. Now what is the difference between mineral and ore? So mineral have definite chemical composition, and ore is the combination of minerals. Now functions, when you will see iron, aluminium, zinc, manganese and copper, these minerals are used for industries, okay. Now important non-metals include core, salt, clay, cement and silica. Stone is used for the building of sculptures, okay. Many minerals have aesthetic and ornamental value like diamonds, emeralds, rubies. The luster of gold, silver and platinum is used for ornaments, and mineral in the form of oil, gas and coal are used as fuel. Now we'll see what are the steps in mining. So first step is prospecting, that is the searching of minerals. Two techniques are used, direct and indirect. Direct means which is done on the surface sample, and indirect is done in deeper areas. Exploration, which is used to estimate the tonnage, how much ton of minerals is present in that particular area, okay. So grade, feasibility and location of minerals. Development, that is the if now from the first two steps you are confirmed that larger amount of minerals are present in this area, so they will open a mineral deposit in that area and prepare access roads to mines, and they will acquire the power source. Then comes extraction and exploitation, that is actual recovery or actual mining is done here. And last is reclamation and closure, that is the process of closing of mine. You have to do the reforestation and restore all the natural things which were there. Same is explained in this slide. Now what are hazards due to mining? Two hazards are there. There is hazards to human being and hazards to environment, that is rock falls and roof falls is there when you consider the human being. There is inadequate ventilation, there is explosion in mines, it causes black lung disease when you are extracting the coal, and if you are extracting the radioactive substance, it can cause cancer, and methane gas from coal is also injurious to health. Now, what are the hazards to the environment done by this mining? It damages the land, it destroys nearby vegetation, and it causes air, water and soil pollution. These are the non-renewable sources, so they cause the permanent loss for future generation. How can you mitigate the hazards? First is eco-friendly mining techniques should be used, like Theobacillus ferrooxidans is the bacteria they have found out for the extraction of gold. Then proper reclamation of mine should be done. You have to ensure the safety of the miners. Then environment protection laws should be properly observed. You can use advanced mining techniques which will not harm the environment. Then more trees should be planted around the mines. How will you conserve the mineral resources? As they are non-renewable, you have to use the 3R, reduce, reuse and recycle. Or you can use alternative substitute for minerals, like fiberglass should be used instead of steel and copper. And whatever waste is generated should be used for the further purpose. Okay. Case study is Sariska Tiger Reserve, the in Rajasthan. Okay. So the forest department of that reserve had leased the land for mining. Okay, so the local people, they filed a public interest litigation in Supreme Court. Rajendra Singh, which is the secretary of this Tarun Bharat Sangh, okay, he pointed out that 70 mines were operating near to this forest, which was depleting the land of the forest. So the Supreme Court ordered closure of all these 400 marble mines, and thus it preserved this Sariska Tiger Reserve. Then we are moving towards the next resources, that is the food resources. Now, what is food? It is any substance that provide the nutrition. Sources of foods are both plants and animals. Fertile soils are being exploited faster than they can recuperate. Okay. So, what are the functions of food resources? They provide nutrition. They maintain immunity in human beings. It acts as a source of nutrients like protein, carbohydrate, vitamins. It provides energy to do work, and it increases learning capability of a human being. What are the problems caused due to food resources? Four problems are there: low yield, then low quality, faulty farming practices, and land degradation. So in this, the major problem is low yield, so we are going to see that. So what are the factors causing low yield? First is overgrazing, okay, which cause loss of vegetation, soil compaction, deficiency of nutrient and soil erosion. Okay. Then second cause is traditional agricultural practices causes low yield. For example, shifting cultivation, burning of agricultural waste and continuous cultivation of single crop. Okay, this causes the low yield. It makes the soil barren. Then comes the effect of modern agriculture. Now, modern agricultural practices also, they cause the makes the soil barren, and it can lead to low yield. First is land degradation. If you are using chemical fertilizers, it is causing eutrophication and blue baby syndrome. Pesticides are causing biomagnification, that is entry of harmful pesticides into the food chain. Super paste, that is the paste become resistant to that. Then effect of soil microbes, useful soil microbes are getting killed due to these pesticides. And then water logging and salinity, that makes the soil barren. How will you conserve the food resources? That is, grow your own food. Okay, then waste less food, which is very important. Crop rotation must be done instead of cultivating a single crop. Use of water efficient crops, use of organic farming, use of organic fertilizers, then biological pest control should be used, and use genetically mutated eco-friendly crops. We'll see the case study First case study is Israel's drip irrigation. Now, Israel is a very arid country. It was very difficult to cultivate crops there. But Israel used drip irrigation system as it is very short of water. Okay, so with this technique, they have improved the efficiency of irrigation by 95%. Okay, so during this period, its food production doubled without an increase in use of water. Okay, so this is a very important case. Then in India, some traditional communities, okay, in the urban and semi-urban town, grow their own vegetables in the backyard. Okay, Calcutta releases its wastewater into the surrounding lagoons in which fishes are reared, and the water is used for growing the vegetables. So here also you can see. Second is problem of salinity in Punjab and Haryana, which is a major concern. That is because of Punjab and Haryana, there are paddy fields, okay, so because of which a large amount of water is required. Okay, so there is a problem of salinity there. Okay, underground water contains high concentration of salt, which comes by capillary action on the surface and make the soil saline. Okay, so that causes salinity. Now, problem of water logging in Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan. So, this project, Indira Gandhi Canal project, now what is doing? It has converted a very large area into waterlogged wasteland. Waterlogged means the soil becomes super saturated with water. Okay, it's which is also not good. Okay, also a very large canal irrigated area of Punjab has become waterlogged and saline. Once the soil becomes waterlogged, the effect is salinity. Okay, over saturated with water. So this is the problems you can say. So and these are the case studies related to food resources. Okay, we'll stop here and we will continue with the next section in the next video.